Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today, I'm excited to share with you this free resource that has free stock video, free music, free sound effects, free templates that you can download for Premiere Pro, and it's called MixKit. Here on the website, you can see if you go to Video Templates, you can download for Premiere Pro, After Effects, Final Cut Pro even, as well as DaVinci Resolve. So in Premiere Pro, up here at the top, you can see that there's a bunch of different categories. From titles and lower thirds, they have over 175 MOGRTs that you can download, motion graphics templates. So for example, here under titles, you can go through and you can browse and you can download. So for example, this one down here, let's say you wanted to download this one, you can just select it. And then on the right here, you can click download free template. After you download, you'll see that it downloads as a zip file. You'll also see that Envato Elements is promoted on this page. And that's because Envato Elements is the parent company. They created MixKit by giving you free samples of some of the larger packs that are available for subscription from Envato Elements. So once it's downloaded, you can double click to unzip the file. Inside the folder, you'll find a preview of what the template looks like, of course. You'll have the MOGRT file, which I'll show you how to install, and some of the templates, not all of them that you download, have a text file with the different fonts that you need to download that are used in the template. So if you don't have Bebesnu, Montserrat, or Kanet installed, you can go to these URLs and install the fonts before you open up Premiere Pro, so that way everything will work out in the right file path when you open up the MOGRT. All right, so from Premiere Pro, make sure that you're in the Captions and Graphics workspace, because this will bring up the Essential Graphics panel on the right, which is where you import the MOGRTs. And there's the text panel, which has a new graphics tab that'll outline all of the text that's currently in the sequence that you have selected. So it makes an easy way to access and edit text from all of the motion graphics that are currently in my timeline that I have. So if I want to change a word here, I can double click and just easily update that rather than having to go through and edit it in the Essential Graphics panel. But more on that later on. For now, let's go ahead and import this MOGRT. So we can go to Essential Graphics, go to the Browse tab, then open up your Finder or the Explorer if you're on a PC, and drag and drop this MOGRT into the Browse tab here to import it. You can also just click on that little plus icon if you prefer to install the motion graphics template from the Finder window. So once that's done, then you need to go through and you need to find it. So you'll need to scroll down in the Browse tab to find this title, and you'll see that it's titled Title 02. If you want to change that name, I recommend clicking on the I for info, and you can go in here, and I'd recommend just typing in MixKit or anything that will help you remember it. You can add some keywords like modern creative animation, and then back here you can go and search MixKit modern. And here we go, now it's easily searchable. You can also select the star to set it as a favorite, so that way you can search just by favorites with that title. So that's a useful way of organizing your assets. You'll also notice that this is completely static. There's no preview animation here. If I search MixKit, I've actually imported different versions of these templates with animations included. So you can see as I hover here, it shows a preview animation of what they look like. And that's because I have a tutorial on how to hack a MOGRT to create an animated preview. So if you want to take the MixKit templates, your favorite ones, and turn it into an animated preview before you import it, you can follow my tutorial right up here to watch how to do that. And none of the MixKit MOGRTs come with this. So if you want to have 10 of my favorite MixKit MOGRTs already with the animated preview, you can sign up for my newsletter below and get those 10 free animated MOGRT previews for free. So let me show you the difference here. So right now this one's static, but I already converted this into an animated preview. Let's drag and drop it into the Browse tab here. And once again, we're going to have to search for Title 02 because that's what it's called here. And now you can see this was the old one that just has a static, and now this one has an animated preview. So definitely, if you want to learn how to create an animated preview, watch my tutorial up here. So I'm just going to delete this one here. I'm going to control click on it and just delete that one. So that way we will just have this one. So mix kit I'm going to search for, and these are all of my favorite mix kit mogrts. Let's show you how to edit them. First, you need to create a new sequence. So you can create a sequence in 4K or 1080p. I'm just going to use 1080p here. And then you can just click on the mogrt that you want to use, click and drag and drop it into the timeline. And then you'll get this warning here. This is just saying that the mogrt has different settings than your timeline. I would recommend just keep existing settings because you can always alter the mogrt using the controls. So keep existing settings. Now we can scroll in and we have this mix kit isometric graphics layer. And once you select it, it'll automatically change it to the edit tab. And here, as we preview, we can then update this text. So instead of modern, let's say we wanted to put Premiere. And instead of new, we wanted to put gal, modern, let's keep that and just put tutorials, for example. And you, of course, you can change the fonts using these text property controls, and you can adjust the positions if you need to, and the size. If I want to make Premiere a little bit smaller, I can use the slider here to make that a bit smaller. And down here, you can adjust the positions of each text if you need to, as well as the colors. So for example, if I wanted to change this color to a yellow-green, and this is what it looks like. And what's really cool about this title is that it's responsive. So it has the animation in and the animation out. So if you just roll this in, it'll make the animation shorter, adaptive to the change. So it'll overall be a shorter animation. A lot of mogrts before, they didn't have this responsiveness, and more authors are now creating this responsive design built into the mogrt, making it super easy. And you can get this for free, which is pretty amazing. So if you ever wanted to duplicate the exact same title again, here's a shortcut. You can press the Option key on a Mac or the Alt key on a PC, click and drag, and then let go of your mouse first before you take your finger off of the Option key, and it will duplicate it. And then you can go in and make edits here rather than going in and dragging it to start over again. So the same process for all of these different MixKit templates. Once you install them, they will be there forever. You'll be able to keep it as long as you need to use in any type of project that you want. One more thing I wanted to show you. If you have a sequence with multiple mogrts, as you can see here, I have multiple inside of my timeline. If you go to the graphics panel, this is a quick shortcut for you to be like, oh, I want to go in and replace this text, rather than having to go over here on the essential graphics panel. It's another place for you to quickly go in and make edits. And this is a new feature, so you can quickly search for a word. So for example, if it's a very long timeline and you had somebody's name and it was way down in the timeline and you didn't want to have to find it, you can go into the graphics panel and search and then quickly make that update. So that's all for these mogrt tips. If it helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. I also have a video up here showing you how to use the MixKit transitions that are free. So definitely watch that if you're keen to try out some of their transitions in your videos. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell. That's all for today's video. And as always, keep creating better video with Gal. See you next time. Bye.